The admission fee at an amusement park is $15.50 for children and $20 for adults. On a certain day, 217 people entered the park, and the admission fees collected totaled $3,782. How many children and how many adults were admitted? So to solve this problem, we're going to set up a system of equations and then solve the system. We're trying to find how many children and how many adults entered the park on this day. So we have two unknown values. So let's let x equal the number of children, and we'll let y equal the number of adults. Now let's sort through the given information. The fee for each child is $15.50, and the fee for every adult is $20. We also know there was a total of 217 people that entered the park on this day, and the total fees collected was $3,782. So one equation will represent the amount of money collected, and the other equation will be the number of people that entered the park. Well, if x is the number of children and y is the number of adults, and there were 217 people in the park that day, this tells us that x plus y must equal 217. And then again, every child has to pay $15.50, and every adult has to pay $20, resulting in a total of $3,782. Which means 15.50, or just 15.5, times x, this is the amount of money collected from the children, plus $20 times y, this is the amount of money collected from the adults, must equal $3,782. So this is our system of equations. If we want to solve this algebraically, we can use the substitution method or the elimination method. Since we can solve this first equation here pretty easily for x or y, I think we'll use the substitution method. So if we subtract x on both sides of this first equation, we can rewrite this as y equals 217 minus x. And now we'll use this equation and perform substitution into the second equation. Since y is equal to 217 minus x, we can substitute or replace this y here with 217 minus x. And this will give us an equation with one variable, and therefore we can solve for x. So we'd have 15.5x plus 20 times 217 minus x must equal 3,782. So now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have 20 times 217, that's going to be 4,340, minus 20x must equal 3,782. Let's combine our like terms here and here. 15.5x minus 20x is going to be negative 4.5x. Now we'll subtract 4,340 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have negative 4.5x must equal 3,782 minus 4,340. That's going to give us negative 558. Let's go ahead and finish this up here. So to solve this for x, we'll divide both sides by a negative 4.5. This simplifies to 1x, or just x. And negative 558 divided by negative 4.5 is equal to 124. Remember, x represents the number of children, so we still have to determine the value of y, which would be the number of adults. So we can use this equation here, x plus y equals 217, to determine y, or we can just use the equation y equals 217 minus x. If we use this equation here, we know that y must be equal to 217 minus 124, which is equal to 93. So this tells us that there were 124 children and 93 adults admitted to the park on this given day. Now remember, if we were to graph these two linear equations on the same coordinate plane, the point of intersection would represent the same solution. So let's go ahead and check that. So here we have the graph of the two linear equations, and here's our point of intersection, where the x-coordinate is equal to 124, which represents the number of children admitted, and the y-coordinate is 93, which represents the number of adults admitted on that day. So this does verify our solution.